Hey folks, good morning from Dhaka, Bangladesh. I hope everybody is doing good and everybody is in good health, which I am not right now. I think I got some fever. I got a little bit sick from last night because since yesterday, there was a weather forecast that the winter is gonna get very, very intense. So weather gets intense means it's gonna get more colder in the winter months. I know many of you in the colder countries are laughing like, ha ha ha, winter, huh? Kidding me? Yes, our winters can be dangerous, which is why I fell sick. Very, very breezy yesterday, very cold. So before this it was just like kind of cold, but it was not that windy. Now it's getting windy and then the winter is gonna come really, really it's gonna take down some of us. So I was very sick last night. I had a date, I went out, had dinner, came back, and then afterwards I think I didn't take my jacket. I got sick. So this morning I got up, I need to have some breakfast. I took some medication for paracetamol, having my tea, the lemon tea. I got some cold going on, but I was like determined, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do this review, right? So today's review is gonna be one fragrance. It's definitely it's unisex to my nose, and this is built for women. So I told you I'm gonna review this. So it's gonna be from Dolce and Gabbana. Light blue for women, pour femme, however you say it. One of my most favorite fragrance of women of all time, right? So I'm gonna talk about this and I'll tell you what are the good things, what are the bad things, all right? And as well as few other things, right? So here we go. So this one, this particular fragrance, it's from the house of Dolce & Gabbana, all right? And it's not a new release. This is from the year 2001. And the perfumer for this is Olivier Cresp, who also happened to do two other fragrances, which is very popular on the men's side. Paco, Rabanne Black Excess, as well as Versace's Menu Fresh. All right, I'm just showing you the box because I don't want to take out the bottle. Right, and I'll tell you why I'm showing you those other two fragrances. All right, so this particular fragrance is made for ladies, and the marketed for ladies, and it is a female counterpart of Dolce & Gabbana light blue for men, right? So this is the light blue for men, for the ladies. Color contrast a bit different. I'm gonna show you the presentation in a while, right? So personally speaking, this actually is a bottle of my girlfriend. So she lent me the bottle to review it and use it for a while. And she wants it back very, very fast because she really loves this stuff, right? And the bottle I have with me, I think it's a 50 ml bottle. Yep. And it's funny, I thought this was made in Italy or somewhere, but it's made in Germany, all right? So 50 ml bottle, EDT, and made in Germany, all right? So the fragrance is classified as breezy, citrus, aromatic, fruity, which I believe is the correct description for this fragrance, okay? And as I told you, the particular fragrance actually is, to my knowledge, it's more of a unisex fragrance than just ladies. So no matter what some rough and tough guy says, yesterday one of our from the group, one of the guys, Moses Navarro, he's a very fun guy. If you guys don't know him, he says stuff might sound offending, but then it's actually very funny. So when said this was like my yesterday's scent of the morning or something like that, and he's like, congratulations my friend, you smell like now all the, what was it, strippers back in 2010 or 2001, I'm not sure. I was like, what the hell? So he meant it in a good way, because strippers, you know, like it or not, they are very high class. They have money, they earn, and then they have good taste, and they can purchase expensive stuff. So if you smell like strippers wearing this, good thing, all right? It's not a bad thing, all right? So, okay, so let me show you the presentation first, which I really, really, really love. This particular fragrance, another thing is, was in my mom's collection some 10 years, 20 years back. My mom, she used to own this, right? And this was one of her signature scents. She really loved it. She used to put this on, like, if she's going out for an invitation party or hanging out with her other aunties and stuff. So, yep. So, I have good memories. I have a lot of good memories of this, and I'm very happy that my girlfriend bought it back so I can once in a while borrow it, all right? So, as far as the presentation goes, first thing, this box is so pretty. I have to tell you right away, this is like one of the nicest presentation ever. very light, beautiful color. I honestly speaking, I try to like this, the men's one. I love the presentation and everything, very nice. It has the sort of like, I'll show you also, similar kind of presentation, but the ladies one is much better. Just showing you, this is the men's one, right? Some similarities, both frosted glass and whatnot, but bottle wise and smell wise, I prefer the ladies one over this, and I'll tell you why, right? So setting aside the men's one, the box, back to the box, it says Dolce and Gabbana. And first thing you notice about this is how pretty and how nice it feels. It has a velvety texture outside and feels so good. Trust me, it feels like a purse. Very comfy, very, very like velvety sort of seat or sofa. Very comfy, doesn't feel like a paper or whatever. So Dolce & Gabbana light blue. It says 50 ml EDT. Bottom is like you get your information. At the side, you get your barcode. On the top, nothing much. The back, you have some ingredients and made in Germany, it says right here. Okay, so pretty nice, very beautiful sort of a presentation. Inside, nothing much, it's just like a typical box inside. But one other thing I told you always, good companies do attention to details. See the compartment inside, the bottles is pretty securely inside, so it doesn't rattle. So which is why it gets additional mark for me. So yeah, pretty nice box, beautiful box. I love this box. All right, it's a collection worthy. If ladies have this, if you, even if you a guy and own this, don't throw away the box. It will look nice in your collection. The thing is, second thing is the bottle. I love this bottle presentation. First thing I love about the frosted glass, and I'll tell you why I like this over the men's one. This is the men's one, men's version, which is very popular also, which is a very good performer, which this isn't. All right, I'll tell you. But this bottle kind of looks like weird. Even the Dolce & Gabbana, the Puram, I don't know, for some reason it looks weird. The shape is kind of awkward. It looks like dwarf. Right? So it could have been better at the guy's side, but then yeah, ladies' side takeaway. Right? So first thing, the bottle says Dolce & Gabbana light blue. It says the EDT and the frosted glass. It looks like Isimia Keludise or that other one just now I showed you. Very nice, elegant, and feels very nice. It's very smooth. All right? It's not the smooth in the guy's one. Very smooth, feels very nice. Top is light blue color, it's like this. It has some edges, ridges at the, yeah, you can see, right? Yeah, it's not exactly like square shape, right? And then this one is like a, sorry, fingerprint bending, but this is plastic, a little bit chromish. Side, back, pretty uniform, pretty simplistic, but the usage of the bottle, the frosted glass looks, it makes it look very nice. And bottom, you get your information. So the bad thing about this, one bad thing about this bottle is, this cap, it doesn't come off very, very easily, which is very good in the men's one. Men's one, I'm just giving you comparison, side by side, you can have some idea. You can just take it off, comes off very nicely, sits securely, good, right? But the ladies one, if you are trying to take it off, I suggest you hold it by the chromish part here. All right, I'm just telling you because it might damage your bottle if you don't do this. Hold it here and then try to take it off from here, the cap. If you don't hold it here and you hold it here, like in the bottle, by the bottle, this part here, the chromish part of the bottle is not very secure. So when you move the cap, remove the cap, what happens is this one starts moving. I'm scared it might come off anytime. So not very well built in that way, right? So hold it by the chrome and then, oh God, and it's very tough to take out also. Not a good one. I don't like this part of this fragrance. Sprayer works all right. I'm gonna show you the sprayer. Works very, very fine. Very good mist, very good sprayer. All right, A class, right? So the bottle presentation and everything, I'm gonna give this 9 minus 1 mark because of that mechanism, all right? So the price wise, it's on the pricey side. This, I haven't seen anywhere discounted. I think she paid about what, around 50, 60, I think, no, it's more than 60. It's like $65 just for the smaller bottle, all right? And the bigger bottle is around $100. Or more, which is more expensive than the men's one, same size. All right, so the ladies version a bit more expensive, just like many other perfumes. All right, so it comes with 50 ml and 100 ml bottle. I don't know if there's a bigger size, but the two bottle sizes. All right, next one, let's go to the notes. All right, and I'll tell you what it smells like and some of the stuff. Right, so the notes in this are from Fragrantica obtained. Right, the notes are the notes are green apple, bellflower, Sicilian lemon, cedar, jasmine, bamboo, white rose, musk, and amber, right? So those are the enlisted notes for you guys. But if you ask me what I get, just spray it right now, right? The best thing about this, I told you my mom used to use this, and the thing magical about this is I haven't smelled anywhere authentic Sicilian lemon kind of a scent mixed with florals and whatever is in this, right? I can pick up all the notes, but it makes you feel very happy. Moment you spray this on, oh, the feel of the fragrance, even if it's on your lady or it's on yourself, it's just magical. It just reminds you of Greece. I remember Greece, something like an ocean, everything is blue, just like the bottle suggested, and it's a little bit like breezy summertime, as well as a little bit spring, a bit cooler, all right? I think that will be the best time to wear this, right? So I pick up on the opening that Sicilian lemon and bit of mandarin orange, that sort of mix. So citrusy opening, bright opening, very breezy, very light and airy, all right? Next goes, I think other notes, I'll pick up a little bit of green apple, that's the fruity aspect, all right? Just a touch, yeah, just a touch. You can see, imagine the peel of the green apple, the green part, if you take it out, not the whole apple. All right, that's what it feels like. And you smell that peel. That's the top note for you. Green apple, mandarin orange, and Sicilian lemon. Very, very summery and very breezy. Very beautiful, light, all right? Then also there, the cry down, that comes very, very fast. That's the horrendous part about this fragrance is for such an expensive fragrance. Okay, so here are two aspects, two things. Yesterday I posted this in a group. One lady was telling me, from the group, Steven's group, that this one performs very well on her. She has good performance on this, but her bottle is from the back in the time. So the two talks about this is either this is reformulated, or she was saying this has an effect that you cannot smell it on your skin after a while, but people around you can, right? So I am yet to test it with my friends surrounding. I'll ask them around if they can smell it after 2-3 hours of application, right? But to my nose, I spray this in 25 minutes, I cannot smell shit. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Zero. It's like ozonic and it's like very volatile. At the same time, it's like some of those hi, bye. That's kind of, so it's kind of, if my experimentation, like my asking about to my friends, if they don't smell this, I'm gonna be very disappointed, because if they cannot smell it, that means the reformulation did take place and the quality of the fragrance is very, very poor, right? Whereas the smell of the original, the Dolce and Gabbana light blue for men, I don't like the smell because it's too much pepper in this. Very summery, breezy, less of citrus, but lasts on you forever. So if you can combine these two, the power of light blue for men, the longevity and the performance in this fragrance, this would be an immortal fragrance, all right? For me, that would make the best fragrance for women in the world. One of them anyway, right? So projection and longevity kind of sucks on this. First time you spray this, yes, you're gonna get good performance, but it's gonna disappear very, very fast. So on the dry down, it's a cedar, it has some other florals and bamboo, musk and amber, right? So I don't get any cedar from this. There's no woodsy feel or strong backbone to this. Very light and airy. Feels like EDC, eau de cologne, that sort of a fragrance. You spray it on, refresh yourself every 15 minutes, gonna be good to go. This bottle, if you use it like that, it's gonna finish within pretty much 1 to 2 months, right? But yeah, so the woodsy vibe I don't get. There's no strong backbone to it, right? You're gonna get the floral in the mid. You're gonna get the jasmine, the white rose. Yes, the florals absolutely come into play. And there's also bellflower, which I never smelled, but I believe, yeah, that flower smells so nice because this smells very, very good, all right? And then the bamboo note. That one, I must tell you, this is the unique thing. That one, the other two, I mean the other one, men's one, don't have. The bamboo note in this is very, very wet. You imagine a little bit young bamboo, green in the forest, a little bit wet, like moist after the rain, very fresh, and then lifts up your senses. You know, it's like, you know, you really feel like, you know, the stones and water running on those stones, and then absolutely bird sounds and forest, absolute peace of mind. That's the kind of feel you get from this on the dry down, even the opening, light bamboo green note, all right? And then in the dry down, nothing fancy, nothing big, dies on very, very gently, musk, all right? White musk. So that's the nose breakdown for you, right? So longevity and projection, very, very sketchy, all right? If you ask me how much would I give out of 10? I'm gonna give this 3 out of 10, that bad. And 3 being very, very generous. Projection for this is kind of funny. When you open, like first time you spray it, it projects very nicely. Everyone's gonna notice you. Like it's almost like 9 out of 10. And you're gonna be like, wow, what a beautiful fragrance, right? Beautiful part is good. Long lasting projection. After a while, it's not gonna make you smile anymore, because it's gonna go from 9 out of 10 to 0 out of 10. Yes, that's bad. I never given any fragrance 0 out of 10. Even my clinic happy, I would give this 3-4. But this one, after 15 to 20 minutes from my experimentation, for this particular formulation, which is a newer one, no one could smell it. My friend, I tell her, like, can you smell it? And she's like, I don't smell shit. Very, very sad story. I hope my experimentation for other people, they can pick it up, all right? So I can give it a little bit more than 0, all right? So for smell, 10 out of 10. I told you guys, this is so beautiful, all right? And this one, if you guys, I told you just a while ago, Olivier Cresp, who did this, as you can see, the color pattern is kind of same. This could easily be the packaging of this fragrance. See the color combination? This is a summer fragrance. This is light, airy, citrusy, all right? This one smells a lot like that, but nowhere close, because it's a bit more manly than the female one. And then Paco, Rabanne Black Excess, even though this is a winter fragrance, but the top note, the citrusy notes, quite close to Dolce and Gabbana Light Blue, all right? So for me, I wear it. I would wear it personally. And then this one has some elements of the bamboo note and everything, which is like Star Walker from Montblanc also has a bamboo note, right? So guys can wear it proudly. Even if someone tells you smell like a stripper, don't care. Strippers are very pretty. They are very classy and elegant. You wish you could be with one, right? So just kidding. This one smells very professional, very, very young, summery. And then the smell wise, I'm going to give this 10 out of 10. Smells beautiful, absolutely gorgeous fragrance. All right, if I ever make a top 10 for ladies, this is gonna be there, and maybe most likely on the top 5. All right, compliments wise, 10 out of 10, no question. Hall of Fame, this is the additional new category I'm adding. This is Hall of Famer fragrance already, because this one is known by all women and loved by them. All right, so 10 out of 10 for Hall of Famer. All right. Excuse me, the tea is getting cold. All right, originality. Yes, this one, the originality, if you talk about, does it smell original? Not really. It smells, that bamboo note is very unique. That one I have to give 10 out of 10, but in general, there's a lot of fragrances that smells in the ladies' side, men's side, this bit of a summery, lemony, and then light and fresh, breezy. A lot of fragrances that smell like that, but that rose and mix of the floral, jasmine, mixed with the bamboo note and the Sicilian lemon up top, makes it kinda original. So I'll give this still 9 out of 10, all right, for the originality. Then next is unisex. As I told you, this one can be unisex, all right? So who like this fragrance? Who is it for? I think this one is perfectly suitable for young women, young individuals, young men. And if you like this kind of a fragrance, bit of citrus, bit of a Sicilian lemon and Mediterranean, like that sort of sea feel, very breezy, light, like greenery at the same time, there's blue skies, clouds. This is for you, men and women, young people, old people, anyone can use this. Very non-offensive kind of a fragrance, all right? Professional people who are going for office, you can keep it in your purse, ladies, because you guys are blessed. We have only pockets, so we're not going to carry around this in our back pockets, but in your purse, absolutely, you can carry this smaller bottle around, very easy. Date, definitely dates. Bit of cooler summer days, autumn days, perfect. Close encounters, for sure. If you are dating your man and you're gonna be getting cozy, put this on, your man's gonna adore you. If you are a guy, your lady's gonna adore you. Both ways it works, all right? Feels, as I told you, breezy, summery, autumn, sexy. It is sexy, for sure. It's very sexy as hell. If I would imagine ladies wearing this, I'm gonna be all over her, which is why I'm all over my girlfriend, right? Then the last one, aromatic. Very aromatic scent, very, very beautiful, non-offensive, and very, it lifts up your mood, seriously. So overall mark, if not for that horrible performance that I got from my experience, this is gonna get 10 out of 10. But always watch out, if your thing is longevity and performance for such an expensive fragrance, you might rethink that do you want to buy this? But if you love the smell of bamboo nut and you give it a try in the mall, if you like the smell, absolutely buy it. But if projection and performance is your thing and you don't want to spend so much, maybe pass. All right. So yeah, it's not a must buy, but one of my favorites. All right. From 2001, survived what 16, 17 years now. Right. So yeah, 10 out of 10 for the smell. But if you take out that performance, everything, maybe 6 out of 10. Performance wise, it kind of sucks. That's it. So thank you very much for watching, ladies, gents, whoever watched it. And I hope to keep this balance up. And I hope I can get a few more bottles from my group so I can review it from my channel. And one quick update is getting to places now in Bangladesh is getting a bit challenging because now a lot of security measures taken up. And then, you know, Bangladesh, some problems there here and there. So security is a concern. So I'll try to take my group members for this month's Good Smellers group. We might go somewhere as a group and we'll do the review outdoors, not in a crowded or noisy place or low light situation. All right. So I'm still looking for a place, thinking of a place. All right. And the second one is the second last update is we wanted to go to this place. As you guys, some of you saw, there was a shop Starlin in Bangladesh, which offer very good original fragrances at a discounted price. We wanted to go there. Unfortunately, there was a huge fire breakdown and then the shop, all the shops, about 200 plus shops, gone down to fire along with their shop. I feel very sad because not only because I missed out on the opportunity, but I feel bad, you know, for the people, business owners. All right. They lost like millions. That's just like some of them, they got broke. So yeah, kind of sad, but definitely we'll find some other shops who can offer us good deals and we can recommend to you. All right. So thank you for watching. Thank you for your time. Really appreciate it. Do look into the beautiful, gorgeous Dolce and Gabbana light blue. I really want to cover this, all right? I'm keeping this for a while. I'm not gonna return it to her, right? Ah, I smell good. See you guys. Have a nice day. Have a nice night. Talk to you soon.